Let's now get the latest stories from our North America Bureau with our correspondent, Romel Conclara.
Good morning, Mike and Nikki. Here's the latest stories making the headline amongst the Filipino community.
We begin with U.S. President Joe Biden and Florida Governor Ron DeSantis setting aside their political differences to help the Sunshine State recover from Hurricane Ian. DeSantis and other local officials are set to brief Biden on the response and recovery efforts. The White House says Floridians should be assured that the state and federal governments are working closely to restore and rebuild.
He's going to be listening to the people who live there who have lost so much. He's going to be talking to the respondents on the ground who have been done a tremendous work.
More than 100 people have reportedly died in Florida and North Carolina after Ian hit Florida's west coast last week and went up north. In sports, the U.S. Open Junior Girls Champion Alex Ayala is back on the court and back to her winning ways. This week, she is competing in the W80 Rancho Santa Fe Open in Southern California.
It's a good restart coming back to the professional circuit. And I think I'm doing very well, and a lot of things that I learned in the Junior U.S. Open. So I'm trying to apply that in my next couple of weeks.
The tournament kicked off this week with Ayala beating Latvia's Denisa Marcinkevičiūtė 6-1, 6-3. On day two, Ayala was near perfect against 22-year-old American Alana Smith, winning 6-0, 6-0. Since winning the U.S. Open last month, Ayala hasn't been taking any breaks. Straight from the competition, she reached the top 16 at Templeton. And while she made history as the first Filipina to win a major in a singles competition, she's neither changing her mindset nor feeling the pressure.
It's really a jungle where everyone really wants to win, so it's good character development, and it helps you with your mindset and always wants you to keep fighting.
And finally, we head to Toronto, Canada, where it was a night of beauty and glamour for over 25 pageant contestants at IPIN's Spring Summer Fashion Symposium. The event, which was held in celebration of the organization's 35th year anniversary, featured a fashion show and the crowning of beauty queens that will compete in upcoming national and international pageants. As a franchise holder, Mutyang ng Pilipinas, IPIN will also be sending two of their candidates to the Philippines this December. The Mutyang ng Pilipinas Canada title holders expressed their gratitude and excitement for the opportunity to represent Canada in the Philippines.
It's important to have that connection between the two countries, and of course I've been preparing my walk and my Q&A and along with my mental health to get ready to be away from my friends and my family.
I feel so extremely grateful. I'm so proud of myself, and I can't wait to continue to represent Canada in the Philippines and make everyone proud and do the best that I can.
And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/tscnews and the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel.